INFJs are the least likely to be who you think they are. While some people may assume they have an INFJ all figured out, there's surely a lot under the surface that hasn't been uncovered. So, what are 9 of the weirdest things all INFJs do that others don't realise they're doing? Welcome, or welcome back, Psychos. Before we get into the video, have you liked and subscribed to our channel? Go ahead, we'll wait for you. Be sure to click the notification bell while you're there so you never miss a video. Alright, let's get right to it, starting with number 1. They plan for everything. Let's just say if you take an INFJ out for dinner to a new restaurant, don't be surprised if they already know what they want, exactly where it is, how to park, and even where they want to sit. This is because INFJs plan for everything, with social events being one of their main focuses. While most INFJs play it cool, for example by scanning over the menu so that they don't look like a total weirdo, they have most likely already planned this all ahead of time. Aside from pre-planning an outfit for the day before, an INFJ may question things like how busy, loud, or close-seated the restaurant will be, to accurately mentally prepare for the atmosphere. This is one of the main reasons why surprises and sudden changes of plans can cause INFJs to panic, because they need the time to properly process what they should be expecting. Number 2. They can disassociate from reality by thinking too deeply. It's no surprise that the INFJ spends a great deal of time in their inner world, but how can INFJs seem like such attentive listeners when they spend so much time focusing on their thoughts? Well, while INFJs can choose to be good listeners when they want to be, they can easily daze off into the inner workings of their mind. Whether it's while completing mundane tasks or simple things like driving to work, INFJs can disassociate their minds from the tasks their bodies are responsible for. They may even get distracted while in the middle of a conversation because they're too busy searching for solutions within their mind. While it may not be totally obvious from the outside, INFJs can be in a serious train of thought and seem completely attentive. Number 3. They have their guard up 90% of the time. INFJs are a lot more private than most people think. In fact, although they are introverted creatures, INFJs have an added layer of hesitancy when it comes to sharing their personal thoughts. Not only is this because INFJs are so used to feeling misunderstood for the way they see the world, but also because they don't want to burden others with their baggage. INFJs want to be the helpers, not the ones receiving the help. So as much as someone thinks they know an INFJ deep down, there's always a lot left to be uncovered. And even then, an INFJ will never give away their own secrets. Number 4. They have fantasized about strangers. INFJs are passionate individuals who love thinking up future scenarios. So when they feel attracted to someone, they can easily visualize potential future scenarios with that person with just a simple act of imagination. While some INFJs' fantasies can be of a sexual nature, this personality type mostly focuses on things like how their parents would react if they met this person, how great life would be financially, how great of a parent they would be, and so on. They may even ruminate on the thoughts of who they think someone is before they get to know them, and then end up disappointed at the fact that this person didn't compare to the fantasized version the INFJ made up in their own heads. Ironically, this elaborate imagination is what makes it sometimes difficult for an INFJ to settle for a relationship in the first place. Number 5. They hold back a lot of what they want to say. This introspective personality type is constantly analysing and picking up on the energy of the world around them. In fact, it's fair to say that most personality types don't come close to doing the same amount of analysing as the INFJ. Therefore, the INFJ sees things that others would normally completely overlook. INFJs know things that others don't know, and at times it can make situations feel tense and uncomfortable, as this introverted type is stuck between saying something and risking being misunderstood for their intentions, or holding back and allowing the situation to work itself out. And because the INFJ is so empathetic towards others, they usually end up keeping their lips sealed to ensure they don't hurt any feelings or stir a pot that shouldn't be tampered with. While it's not so noticeable from the outside looking in, if an INFJ knows something that others don't, they're probably screaming inside wanting to tell someone. Number 6. They can see two sides in everyone. Most INFJs have a tendency to want to see the best in everyone, and although that may be difficult in some situations, the INFJ believes that there are two sides to every personality, yin and yang. Hot and cold, highs and lows, whatever you want to call it, the introspective INFJ loves to analyse the behaviours of others, and after time, it becomes very apparent that not everyone is as shady or angelic as they may seem. While this allows INFJs to see the good in people, it allows them to remain silently sceptical of seemingly good people until they really know them inside out. They know everyone makes mistakes, but they also know the difference between a mistake and a behaviour. This is why, above all else, INFJs require authenticity and genuinity in the people they consider to be within their closest circle. Number 8. They can really hide their nervousness. Just as INFJs can make it seem like everything is just fine and dandy on the outside while struggling on the inside, they also have the ability to hide their introverted anxiousness when in social situations. In fact, some people are surprised to find out that the INFJ they know is actually introverted. This is because since an INFJ understands human behaviour and how to have a proper human encounter, they know what it is they have to do to come off as likeable and confident. While they may be feeling overwhelmed, uncomfortable, and disinterested on the inside, they are able to make it seem like they are totally vibrant, happy, and excited to socialise on the outside. Of course, it's fair to say that some INFJs are more introverted than others, and it all depends on the social situation. And number 9, they sometimes don't understand themselves. INFJs can be super convincing that they have their whole lives figured out, when in reality, they are just as lost as everyone else. Although most INFJs would rightfully argue that they have a deeper understanding of the purposes of human experience and the lessons that we're all here to learn, they still have their own conclusions when it comes to playing the role of a successful human on Earth. Oftentimes, INFJs struggle to understand themselves as a whole, including their feelings and future goals. Although they ask themselves all the introspective life questions, sometimes INFJs still don't really know if where they are in life is where they need to be, if who they're with is who they're supposed to be with, and if they're making the right moves towards the future that they're not really sure about. INFJs know exactly what they don't want, but when it comes to understanding what they do want, it can be overly challenging. Well, that's it for today, Psychos. Let us know in the comments below if you're an INFJ that does these seemingly odd things. Don't forget to leave us a like, share this video with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel for more Psycho videos.